Today we'll solve a problem on continuous beams. You can see here in this problem, we have three spans. The first span is 4 meters and the load is a point load of 20 kilonewton. Second span is 3 meters and the load is 2 kilonewton per meter. And the third span is 2 meters. Here it is a UVL of 3 kilonewton per meter. This is a UDL of 2 kN per meter. The first support is fixed, second is a roller, third is a roller, and fourth is a roller. So now how to solve using the StatPro, using StatPro. So for that, what we will do, we will go to STAD. We will go to STAD. We will go to STAD, open the STAD Pro, and I have given the file name as problem one, continuous beam. Continuous beam. And okay. Continuous beam. Now, what you should do is you should go. Or I will go start with the new one. When you open the STAD Pro, you will find these things. Go to plane, then continuous beam problem one. Okay, that is the file name. And wherever you want, you can save in that directory. Okay, and you should always see to that the units are in meters and kilonewtons. Go to next, add beams, click on add beams if it is not there. Then you finish. You'll get something like this. Then snap node or beam, just cancel it. You will get like this. And here, this is the place where you have to enter the coordinates. We have the first beam starts at x value equal to 0. Is it not this? Since it is a beam is along x-axis, there will be no y coordinate and the z coordinate. So x value for the first node, it is 0. Okay. For the second node, if you remember the problem, it is 4 meters. 4 meters. When you give 4 meters here, x value is 4 meters, that is the coordinate. You get inclined, it notes inclined like this. Go to view from Z. Okay. And the third node was at a distance. The second beam was the span of the second beam was 3 meters. Therefore, from the beginning, the coordinate is now it becomes 7, 0. So therefore, you give x value is 7, remaining 0. And the fourth node. The last span was only 2 meters, then the total x value becomes 9, 0, so it is 9 meters. So just click here and you can just zoom out and see the nodes. This is 4, 0, 7, 0, and 9, 0. Yeah. Here it is. This is 9, 0. You have all the four nodes now. This is one way of creating the nodes. And now you have created the nodes and you need to add beams. Click on add beams. Then click left click here with the, on the first node and click on the second node. Click on the second node, click on the third node, click on the third, and then the fourth. There are various other methods are also there, easiest methods, which you can see later. So this is how we have created the beam. The other way of creating the beam is, you can just observe. The first node, you have to always come here and create U000 as the coordinate. For creating the second node, what you can do, you can go to the node cursor, select this, and give Control C, Control V, copy and paste. Copy this node to the distance of, first span is 4 meters, is it now? So for the 4 meters, you can give X value equal to 4 meters. Then give OK. Give OK. This is the second node which is formed. Then you can select the second node. The third node comes from here, it is from the second node. The third node is at a distance of 3 meters because the span of the second beam is 3 meters. Then view Control C, Control V as X is equal to 3 meters. View OK. Then the from the third node to the fourth node, the distance was, the last span was 2 meters. Then you copy this and paste it at a distance of 2 meters. X is equal to 2 meters. This is also another way which may be, it may found easier when you work on the problems further and further. Now go to add beams, click here, then click here as you did earlier. Then this forms the beam. This forms the beam. Next is you have to provide support. You have first support is a fixed support, then you have roller supports. Then for that, what you should do, you should go to general, then exactly opposite to that, you have support, click on the support, you get this box. Now you have to create the support. For creating the support, go to create, you have fixed, pinned, fixed, but enforced, all those the supports are there. Since the first node, you have fixed support, you can directly give fixed, add. Then in the second, third and fourth, you have roller support. You don't have any roller support here. For that, what you should do, you should go to fixed butt. You know, in the roller support, there will be only vertical reaction. It is restrained in only one direction. All other directions must be released. You have to release all other directions. Only FY you should leave as it is so that you get the reaction there. Okay, you add. Now you click on the first support, click on the first node where you have to assign this, then go here, assignment method, assign to the selected node, just press assign, you will get that that support there. Then all the remaining nodes you have to give the roller support. For that, you click on the roller support, select all the remaining by dragging. Okay, then assign here. Yes, you can see all the three was assigned with the roller support. Next is you have to add the loads. For that, you can see here you have load definitions. Click on that, go to load case detail. There you just click there, you add. You have primary, you can keep the load type as none. You have other options, dead, live, so many other options are there. You can see all those things later. So this you can keep it as none. And here you give some naming as loading. Loading, add here, and close this. Go to loading, click on loading, then go to add. You can create whatever the loads you want. So many types of loads are there. For our case, you should go to member load. In member load, the first one is uniform force, which is UDL that we wanted. And we want concentrated force. This gives you the point load. And we want linearly varying load. This gives you the UL. So in the first span, you had your concentrated load. Click on concentrated load. The load was 20 kilonewton. See, in STAT you should give minus 20 because it is positive upwards and negative downwards. Okay, if you give plus 20, then the load will not act in the downward direction. Instead, it will act in the vertical direction. And where do you want this load? You saw the at the mid span the load was given. Since the span is 4 meters, this distance, you can see in this diagram, the P is at a distance of D1. So that D1, we should give it as 2 meters. Then we will get it at the center. Okay, you add this, In the second span, what we have, UDL is there, go to uniform force. Uniform force, the load value is around minus 2 kilonewton meter. Yeah, 2 kilonewton meter, minus 2 kilonewton per meter. Since it is acting on the full span, you need not worry about D1, D2, D3. Okay, you add. Then the third one, you have linearly varying. You can see the first diagram. Here it is linearly varying. W1 is the starting node and W2 are the end node. So W1 value, in our case, it is 3 kilonewton per meter and the end value is 0. So therefore, you have to give 0 here. Okay, then you add, close. You can see here all the three loads have come. Okay, now we will assign one by one. On the first beam, you need to provide this first load, which is a point load. Just click on that and give assignment method, assign to the selective beams. You can see one point load here. The second load, you can just add on the second span, add here, and you can see the UDL. And the third load, on the third span, you can see UVL. You can see here the UVL has formed vertically in the vertical upper direction. It is because I have not given minus 3. Okay, change, close. Now it becomes UVL, right? Now the load is in ascent, everything is ascent, but any beam, if you there will be a cross section, there will be E value, there will be I value for that. If there is no cross section, no I value. So since in the problem I value is not given, what you can do, go to property, define, give some sample beam like 0.1 meter by 0.1 meter. Otherwise the analysis will not run. Now you click, take this, select the entire beam, give assign to the selected beams. This got assigned. Now you can go for analysis. Go to comment, analysis you have, perform analysis. No print, okay. Then go to analyze, run analysis, save. Yeah, you will get like this. Here you should see that there should be zero error, zero warning and zero nodes. Okay, done. We are done with the analysis. Now we have to look at what is the bending moment and shear force. So here you have bending moment MZ. This will give the bending moment diagram. And you can see a very small diagram you can see. So if you want to see a larger diagram, what you can do is you right click and go to labels. Here you have scales. Just reduce MZ, 1-0 of MZ. Go to make it as 10. Apply, okay. Now the scale has increased and reduced. And you can see the larger size of the bending moment diagram. Now if you want the values, there are various methods. One is you can double click on this, go to shear beam, and you can see what is the bending moment here, what is the bending moment here, and at all other points you can, if you can move this, you can see at 0th point you have 11.9, then at 0.33 meter you have 8, then other span, anywhere you want, they have given few values, you can just refer to that. Okay, that is one way. Close. The other way, if you want the value here itself, on the diagram itself, then what you can do, you can go to post processing, click OK. Then here, you first give the bending moment diagram, then go to result, view value, beam result, you can give end value and maximum values, and if you want the midpoint also you can give, and you should click on annotate, close this. You can see that here the bending moment values have come. Here it is 11.913, then 10.959, some values there. Here since they have merged, what you can do, you can just double click here, go to shear beam, and you can see what is the bending moment here. It is 6.17. Again, here also you can just click on, and you can see this side, left side, it is 6.17. Okay, and all the other points you can see the bending moment values, bending moment value. And you can, what you can observe is this is fixed support, and hence you have the tension on the top, and mid span you have tension bottom, again at the support tension top, and you have zero bending moment here since it is a roller support. Okay, then if you want to look at the shear force diagram, you can click on FY, you get the diagram like this. Again, you can go to scale, reduce 10 in the shear Y. Okay, and you can find the larger diagram. And again, to view value, go to view value, beam result. Now we want the values of shear force. You have to click on these things, you annotate and close, you get the shear force diagram and the values. Okay, this is how this is what you have to understand in the continuous beams. Okay, therefore I will end the video. I hope you have understood how to analyze the continuous beam.